Just 24 hours into Florida Senate race and the gloves are off. The attack ads are flying. Governor Rick Scott announced Monday he is challenging Senator Bill Nelson. NBC2 chief political correspondent Dave Elias is looking at just how dirty this fight could get.
Yeah, political experts are predicting tens of millions of dollars will be spent to win, and political PACs expected to spend even more. Much of that money going toward attack ads that are already airing, and many voters say they're expecting a knockdown, drag-out fight.
This is going to be a major contentious race.
Political science students at FGCU discussing the Senate seat that's grabbing headlines.
I've decided to run for the U.S. Senate.
As Governor Rick Scott made the announcement, Democrats launched this ad on social media.
He was caught shamelessly deleting the voicemails, destroying evidence, and washing the blood from his hands.
Students watching the ad had strong reactions.
I can see the older generation looking at that and being frightened and saying, wow, that gives me something to think about.
Yeah. Like, I feel like more of us laughed at it than took it seriously.
Political science professor Sandra Pavelka issuing this warning.
Well, I think this is just the beginning. This is day one. They started off with a bang.
I know that politics gets dirty.
Lee County GOP chair Jonathan Martin calls the early attacks by Democrats desperate.
The Democrats are going to have to lob as many attacks as they can because Governor Scott has done a tremendous job.
It's our job to inform the voters why you should stick with Senator Bill Nelson.
Lee County's Democratic chairman predicts even more ads focusing on the governor's political relationships.
Rick Scott was one of the first people who endorsed Trump, and we're not going to forget that. We're going to remind voters of that.
These students say no matter how dirty it gets, it won't deter them.
Even though it'll turn me off a little bit, I'm still, like, you know, going to go to the polls.
Now, just 24 hours into his campaign, Scott is already facing federal elections complaint. Citizens United, which leans Democratic, says that Scott used a political PAC designed to help President Trump to one now dedicated to fund Scott's campaign. Live in the control room tonight, Dave Elias, NBC2.